Hi, I'm Corey Jinks. I'm a trail rider from Ontario, Canada.
My name is MJ Thompson. I'm a Ski-Doo trail ambassador. Hey Corey, what's up?
Well, you know, it's that time of year again.
Is that still packed from last year?
I might have left it in there, yeah. But, I mean, it's legible, right?
Dude, still? It's wet.
It's musty.
It's disgusting.
It's better than no map. My first ride of the year is probably going to be a long one, and I'm trying to organize it all and make sure I'm ready to go for the season. Hence the backpacks. We want to make sure we're ready. I want to make sure I have everything I need on the long hauls because I know I'm prepared, but generally most everyone else isn't. I'm definitely a minimalistic packer. I like to pack what is necessary, but also have a couple extra things. I don't underpack, but I don't overpack. The small bag is my daily trip bag, the 11 liter link. Pretty much just your quick reach stuff goes in this bag, some zip ties. This is my miscellaneous long haul bag. It's the more mechanical failures and issues type of bag. So we've got a spare set of gloves, booster cables, those deep freeze nights, the actual toe straps. Again, you hope to not need these, but man, do they work good when you have the proper straps because these go around the spindles and to the sled appropriately. Then you got a rock, paper, scissors. Who's actually gonna pull the guy because I don't like doing it. Tend to carry duct tape. Don't really use it that often, but the time you might need it is the time you're gonna have it, so I always bring it. So in the long haul, this big bag comes with me, goes behind the seat. Always am disappointed in myself if I forget to bring the hotel slippers. The hotel slippers are super clutch. You're gonna walk outside, so now you gotta put your boots on. A must you can live without, but man, it's nice to have them. And probably the last thing that I hopefully never need to use is the toilet paper on the side of the trail. Again, I'd rather have it than not have it. You know, it's going to be a good safety net one day. Definitely getting excited though. This gets me excited.
I'm looking forward to that first ride where you just push the throttle and it just takes you away. It's the freedom. It's unbelievable. I've been packing for overnight trips, snowmobiling, probably for the last 20 years. And over the 20 years, I can't even believe how much stuff is in there, but everything has a purpose. How I pack for my ride definitely changes based on who I'm riding with. And a lot of the times it depends on how self-sufficient I need to be. So between a long ride and a short ride, I would say the biggest difference of what I take on a long ride is provisions, such as extra oil, dry belt, and that all goes in my link bag. No matter how much I'm carrying, it seals tightly and nothing moves around in it. So this is how I pack my link MXZ seat bag. Basically, I want to make sure in the bottom I have everything I need for changing a belt. I have zip ties. Those are useful in countless scenarios. Next up, I have just a little safety kit. You just have to think about what you might need if you have to stay on the side of the trail. I have some homemade fire starters, cotton pads soaked in wax, and also birthday candles, which have also proven to come in very handy. And just something waterproof to keep you dry. So this is actually just a cheap shower curtain, but it's going to make a difference if you're stuck on the side of the trail. A lot of this stuff, once I put it in my bag for the season, it stays in there. And I put all that in there and I usually have room to pack some snacks on top. There, ready for a day of riding.
No, I've got the day bags and I'm trying to organize it all and make sure I'm ready to go for the season. You know, there's a lot of different things you can add for different trips.
Do you take a bathing suit?
I'll take a bathing suit. Or that day's worth of underwear is worth getting wet too, so.
Anywhere you go snowmobiling, and it doesn't matter what brand you're riding or who you're with or how they're riding, everybody helps each other out. That's what snowmobiling is all about. It's not just about putting on lots of miles. It's about where you go, who you see, what you do. It's a lot of fun.